Now, I have had a few instances in my life where I have come across the paths of very famous people. At least they were famous to me. I was impressed by who I came across. I can remember in San Francisco years ago in the early 80s, I went to Golden Gate Park. And out walking out of one of the museums was Lou Rawls. I mean, if you're old enough, you know who Lou Rawls was. And there he was right beside me. I can remember even before that, at a football game at Oklahoma State University, they had the Cleveland Browns come and play another professional team in an exhibition game. And there, walking right in front of my seat, was Red Fox, you know, Sanford and Son. And you won't know this other guy, but I was at a movie theater in Kansas City, Missouri, and waiting outside the bathroom for one of my kids to come out. And here came another father with his kid, sent him in. I looked at him. He was Jeff Montgomery, who was the number one relief pitcher for the Kansas City Royals. So I thought, wow, you know, these people just keep coming across my path. Probably the most interesting was when I was at seminary in California, and I worked at a tennis club near the seminary, and I was standing there watching over the tennis courts. I was security guard, so I was kind of watching, making sure nothing was getting out of hand, watching these guys play tennis, these rich guys, you know, playing tennis. And up next to me walked a guy. I didn't even turn to look at him. And then somebody on the courts spoke to him. And I heard him answer them back, and I thought, I have heard that voice before. And I looked over, and there standing dripping wet in a Speedo bathing suit was Robin Williams. And he looked me in the eye, and Robin Williams says, "How you doing?" You know who you are. You know, supposedly Cary Grant had that happen to him, where a guy came up to him on the street and said, "You know, you're rock." No, and he said, "Well, Cary Grant, no, you're not. That's not it. You're." But I want to do that with Robin Williams as well. But you know, I'm very familiar with Robin Williams. I know I've seen a lot of his movies, especially the movies that are kid oriented. I've seen a lot of those, and I'm familiar with a lot of things that are true about his life. But I bet you, if you stopped Robin Williams on the street today and you asked him, "Do you know Guy McGraw?" He'd say, "Who?" I have no clue who Guy McGraw is. You know, I know a lot of facts about Robin Williams, but that doesn't establish a relationship. The relationship established on something much deeper. And some of you here this morning may know a lot of things about God. You may know a lot of stories out of the Bible. You may know what God is supposed to be like, what the Bible describes him as. You may know what it means to pray to God, you know, what the language to pray is all about. But John's question for you this morning is, do you really know him? Do you know him at the level to have relationship with him? You know, in Matthew 7, Jesus said that there are going to be some people doing some pretty amazing things when it comes to religion. They're going to do miracles. They're going to cast out demons. They are going to even prophesy in God's name. And Jesus is going to say, "But I never knew you. We never had a relationship. Yes, you knew enough about me to do some things in my name, but you never, ever knew me and had a relationship with me." And John's question this morning and my question is, that do you have a relationship with Christ, and is that evidenced by things in your life?